So where does digital innovation fall short? Does it fall short in implementation, change management, or actual technology limitations?
You know, I guess the safe answer is it's a little bit of all three. Most digital technologies are still, I would call, more experimental, and the technology may be proven, but its application within a clinical trial isn't necessarily proven. So the implementation of the digital technology in the context of the trial from a patient perspective is one area where there's still a lot of work to be done. And we talked during the session about working patient back, patient centric. And that goes for designing of the trials, but it goes in terms of designing the digital technologies, you know, to be used in the trials. And then change management, in some ways, I don't think that's really a fair one. I don't think we can expect patients to have to change what they have to do in trials. I think we have to adapt to them. So the change manager would then be on the sponsors and the CROs who are running the trials and their willingness to change. I think we're seeing a lot of change happening. So I would be less hard or critical in terms of that. There seems to be a lot of flexibility right now to try new things. You know, the pandemic has obviously helped accelerate that. So less harsh on the change. And then the digital technologies, I think it goes back to the implementation. If it's not patient-centric developed, if it's not really understanding the user, and in the cases of trials, potentially the health and limitations of the user, then it's going to come up short. So, you know, we're seeing a lot of iterative improvements. And I think it's really important that we start to iterate more and more, not just within the trials, but within the patients. We covered on this quite a bit during the session, that, you know, we've taken a lot of digital technologies designed for healthcare and we're adopting them into trials. We haven't necessarily done enough, and there is some great examples out there, but we haven't done enough to look at the trial per se and start from the patient and from scratch and say, what do we need to do and build for the patient? There are some digital trial platforms out there. There are a number of companies innovating, you know, but they're still small. I can count them on two hands, right? So until that happens and we're working ground up to innovate the technology from scratch, it's also going to still be a shortcoming.